Alright, so I'm going to be washing a duvet and I'm going to be washing it on cotton 60 with quicker wash. So the duvet is here. Hold on. So this duvet has been laying down the back of my bed for about 3 or 4 months since I got my weighted blanket. So it's not been used, it just going to put it somewhere else other than down the side of my bed. Actually, no, I'm going to put it back on the side of my bed, but I'm going to clean down there first. So I'm giving it a wash because it's got all sorts of stuff all over it. And I don't even know what half of the stuff it probably is. Is that one that's enough to do a service mode spin? Yeah, that'll be fine. Alright, so with this I can actually put the detergent straight in, but I'm not going to. So I'm going to deflate it by spinning, not that it needs a deflation spin at all, but I'm going to spin it up in service mode anyway, as I do with all duvets and pillows and stuff like that. Let's just hope we don't glitch, because it likes to glitch on service mode a lot. There we go, we got through it fine with no glitches. So as it's a duvet, it doesn't need as long as the pillows. And since it doesn't actually have any air inside it, so I'm going to turn it off now and prepare the detergent. So as usual, the detergent we're going to be using is these All Matte Stain Lift Colour Technology Tablets. And I'm going to use, because I'm going to use my washing balls and see if they do their job. So, washing balls, a bit like tumble dry balls, but it's supposed to be able to be used in the washing machine as well. I've used dry balls before in the washing machine, believe it or not, I've used dry balls in the washing machine for washer dryers, so they can survive 1400 RPM spins, I can tell you that, because I put them in my 1400 RPM and 1200 RPM machines for the drying cycles. But these are supposed to be able to survive the wash as well. So I've got two for the washing machine, two for the dryer. We're going to see if they can survive the washing machine through an actual wash cycle. So first of all, I'm going to put these into the drum underneath the duvet. And if they do break apart, I'm not going to be too bothered about it because they only cost like £4. So then these are going to just go in there. And what they're supposed to do is eliminate the need for softener in both dryers and washing machines. So even if you hang it up to dry, it should eliminate the need for softener, apparently, because it should come out with the clothes feeling very soft. And it should also help washing because of the same principle of the way it helps drying in dryers, by making the clothes tumble around more. I don't know how that will work when there's water in the machine, but I guess we're going to find out. So cotton 60 and quicker wash, that's going to take 1 hour 29. I put everything in there, so just going to start that and let it do its thing. hungry. I'm going to make myself some food. Time for a bacon and sausage sandwich. Thank you. tell if the balls are doing their job at the moment. They're not disintegrated, so that's a good sign. Excuse me. I know they can take the heat because they've been in the dryer. And dryers are hot. Well, quite obviously, dryers are hot. Thank you. Wait, can this stick to the front of the machine?
I keep forgetting to start my timer. I brought this in here to time the wash cycles to see if they're as long as they say they are. But I keep forgetting to actually, like, for a start, put the battery in, and two, actually start it. So that ping you heard, was it? I mean, that kind of sticks.
Whoops, I left it on the group chat. Ah, I see my timer has decided it was going to slightly slide down the side of it. How I can get this to stick so you can see it.
that side. It looks like it will fall down all night.
I mean, that looks like it will stay up all night. Obviously, I'm not timing it because it would be illogical to start timing it now, considering it's already like halfway through the cycle. See what temperature it's at. This one is running down. Yeah, 46. It doesn't heat very well on quicker wash option. Yeah, that's not going to stay up.
Magnets. The metal's not quite the right material. Is it down there? No.
Oh, it's down there.
Find some blue tack, I suppose, or just something to stick it down with, just so you can see it while it's doing the wash cycle.
I'll find something.
Mm-hmm. found a way of sticking it to the machine. Got a little bit of purple tack there. Don't know why it's purple, but it just is. Let's try sticking it on two parts of the magnet. I wonder if that'll stay.
That looks like it's staying.
So I'll start that for the next wash.
Anti-suds phase. And last time I washed a duvet in this machine, it did a suds lock, and that's the only time this machine suds locked. I've only washed a duvet once in here. This is the second time I've washed a duvet in here. Go. No suds lock. But to be fair, it wasn't this same duvet that I washed last time, so it might have been more absorbent the last one. First rinse. I feel like it only does two rinses on quicker wash, judging by the time left. I think it does. I don't use quicker wash often enough. It must do two, because normal does three. And all quicker wash does is take off a rinse. Actually, to be fair, it does take off a little bit of the wash cycle on Cotton 60 at least, because it goes from 1 hour 57 to 1 hour 29. But then the only problem is it doesn't heat properly to 60. a bit of water. You don't usually use that much. Yeah, it doesn't usually use that much. I'm sure of that. Yeah, I don't think they work quite the same as when the clothes are dry. Because wet clothes are obviously heavier. It's 22 degrees on the roof. And it's 14 degrees on the floor. I mean, this is when I wish I lived on the roof. Since 19 extra rinse for the bedding and towels. Or cost since 19 pre wash. I'll do pre wash, I'm not doing pre wash ages. I don't even know that much more time. I might put the bath mats in just because. Well, this is the second look, and I've done two spins after that. I mean, before that, I did two spins for spin races. Virtual spin races, which you're going to see on YouTube in a while. Not on my channel, on... Got who it is now, but nearer the time I'll announce it anyway. There's like a massive group chat a massive group chat's been released. Oh, I think it's Washer Night. Is the person's name. It's a second interim. Are still together. If I put them together at the start of the wash, they're still together now. In the dryer, they're definitely going to stay together. But the dryer turns a lot, it turns slightly faster than washing machines do. Some dryers distribute on certain cycles. I think beko dryers distribute on the wool cycle. There we go. Here's the suds lock. This is why I like washing duvets.
That wasn't a big sock drop, but it was something. Soften the wrinkles. I don't know how long that timer goes up to. Well, the balls seem to have survived. I'll put them in with the bedding and towels then, in that case. Because it looks like they are designed for washing. Because I've seen people say that they dumbly try to put dryer balls in the washing machine and then they
got ended up in tiny pieces after a single wash. And this isn't the most gentle machine in the world. Considering they're still intact on the final rinse. Pretty good actually. Then again, I suppose it is a big item. The proper test will be on Cosens 90 with pre-wash. Oh, it's annoying. It doesn't do the... it doesn't do pre-wash spin like the LG does. The LG does a spin after the pre-wash and before the main wash. Actually the most quietest things in the wash. Oh, we're about to go into final spin. There is no softener in this wash at all, so the duvet comes out very in. Well, duvets don't really need softener, that it doesn't really make a difference to how they feel, it's more about how they smell. Obviously it's not going to smell of softener, because that's not what those walls do, they're supposed to make the clothes soft. Well, in the dryer at least. The drier ones are supposed to aerate the clothes to make them more softer at the end of the drying cycle and to dry them faster. The washing ones are a different story. I'm not sure how they're supposed to work in the washing. Spin there. It decides to spin first attempt. Not that it's going to spin that up, because that's the drain. see the sunspot. It's a water lock more than a sunspot. It's a little water lock, tiny little water lock, but you can't really see it. well then.
That's finished. So let's turn it off. Open the door. So they survived really well. They're still really, really solid actually. Not sure about that one though. It's a bit of a
little bit of a, well, looks like a tiny opening there. You can't really see it properly on camera.
I'll wash it with the next one and see what happens. I'll wash it with the towels and see what happens. Duvet's dry, so it has brilliant. I'm going to put that in the basket next to the machine. Actually, I'm going to see. So I don't think it needs another rinse, so.
So, hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, then please leave a thumbs up and a comment. And I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.